UW360 is proudly supported by Pacific Office Automation, copy, print, workflow, and IT, problem solved.
I feel like $1 million, actually.
Ted Daniels has a second chance at life.
I just thought I was a dude just getting a heart. You know, my card got drawn. I was the lucky choice.
The logging truck driver from Aberdeen was the lucky choice to receive a donor heart in the first U.S. transplant in a just-started trial of the organ care system, known as the heart in a box. The technology allows surgeons to pump blood through a heart and monitor the organ's function as it travels from a donor to a recipient.
I feel real good.
Ted, who was diagnosed with congestive heart failure a decade ago, is the first of dozens of patients around the country on whom doctors will be testing the new device.
I can honestly say that's a very proud moment to know that I am patient number one. The excitement is wound up that, you know, I'm kind of a trailblazer.
Our expectation every time we do a transplant is that we're doing the best possible surgery for our patients and that we're going to have an outstanding outcome. And so, though that's the expectation, there's still a sense of relief when things go as planned.
UW Medicine is one of seven centers in the country taking part in the trial of TransMedic's portable organ care system and the first to actually use it. The breakthrough technology, which is already being used in Europe, allows doctors to transport a donor heart from a much greater distance than before, up to 3,000 miles away, which greatly increases a transplant patient's chances of finding a heart. By continuing to circulate blood through a donor heart, the device can give surgeons 8 to 10 hours between harvest and transplant, as compared to only 4 to 6 hours with the traditional mode of organ transport using a cooler.
This is very exciting for us. We anticipate that it's going to do well for a very long time. And so that's exciting. The fact that we have used some technology to facilitate that is actually even more exciting.
Ted doesn't know who his donor was, only that his heart traveled 1,500 miles, still beating, to eventually be placed in his chest, a concept he calls mind-boggling.
The idea to live longer, I wasn't quite ready to check out. I got too much more stuff to do.
Which is why, despite enduring years of severe heart disease and now transplant surgery, Ted Daniels considers himself a lucky man.
I get more life. I get to see things that I never watched my girls grow up. Spend a couple more years with my wife. Might enjoy that.